You know what these remind me of?
What? Shoe soles? Checkers?
Nah, ergonomic keyboards. Actually, they look like ortholinear keyboards.
Mix, what the fuck are you talking about?
Mick, they're everywhere. I see ortholinear keyboards everywhere.
Nick, you need help. Go see a therapist.
Hi Digmates, I'm Dominique, and in this video, I'll be talking about ortholinear keyboards, what makes them different from staggered keyboards, and what you need to know when transitioning from the traditional one to the waffle. Huh? I mean, to an ortholinear keyboard.
Go see a therapist.
First, what's the difference between a staggered keyboard and an ortholinear one? Simply put, conventional keyboards have keys arranged in rows that are not aligned, aka staggered. This design was copied from the first ever typewriters. Each key was a lever that needed to reach the paper, and staggered rows allowed that. What about ortholinear keyboards? Well, the word ortho means straight, and linear means arranged in a straight line, so I don't think that needs further explanation. Instead of conforming to the traditional layout, they use a grid-like arrangement. This layout allows for a more natural movement of the fingers to reach the top and bottom rows. However, our fingers aren't all the same length, so why should we place them all in a row at the same height? That's why on most ergonomic ortholinear keyboards, the columns are staggered according to the length of the fingers. So technically, we shouldn't call them ortholinear, but columnar. Many people use both terms indistinctively. This columnar stagger promotes a more intuitive finger placement and further reduces wrist and finger strain. But the big question remains, are ortholinear and columnar keyboards more ergonomic? Theoretically, an ortholinear keyboard can enhance typing, speed, accuracy, and comfort. They break away from tradition and bring you a step towards your ergonomic journey. But to give you a complete answer to the question, we'd need to dedicate an entire video for that. So make sure you subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified once that's uploaded. Transitioning from staggered to columnar. Let's say you've just received the new columnar keyboard you've waited for a lifetime. But the thing is, it's your first time using one. What are your next steps? Well, first, learn how to touch type. If you're already a proficient touch typist, skip this and go to step two. But if you're not, then listen up. Touch typing means you need to start using all your available fingers and pressing the right keys with them. No cheating. Typing Club and Typing Study are some websites where you can practice. And you can also have fun learning with games like Epistory. Although some of us old schoolers learned with games like The Typing of the Dead. You can practice on your staggered keyboard first while you wait for your columnar keyboard. If you have a programmable keyboard, like the Dygma Race, you can use the LEDs to color the keys to know precisely which finger presses which key. We recommend practicing 10 to 20 minutes a day until you can finally comfortably say you know how to touch type. Step 2, get rid of bad touch typing habits. There are some touch typing mistakes that you can make on a staggered keyboard that are forgivable. But when you bring those mistakes to your columnar keyboard, the consequences can be detrimental. For example, pressing Q and P with the ring finger, or pressing X with the middle finger, or using your index finger to press C. This doesn't fly on ortho keyboards. You'd hit the wrong key, or worse, two keys at once. So get rid of those bad habits, master the alphas, and learn exactly which finger should press each key. Practice is the best advice we can give for this step. Understandably, you'll get frustrated, you'll probably become unproductive for some time, and barely get any work done. So, how many minutes or hours a day should you practice? We asked different people about their experiences when transitioning to a columnar keyboard. And there are basically two schools of thought. Some go all in and use their new keyboard the whole time, no matter what. Others set aside time to practice daily while using their staggered keyboard to stay productive.
How many hours did I practice? About 8 hours, my normal working hours.
So I started using my columnar keyboard just about half an hour a day.
I was just answering emails for 8 hours a day, and by the third day I was already as fast as before.
I was really slow at the moment, And then maybe at the second week, I was able to work for a couple of hours using my Columnar keyboard. I was still slow, maybe 20, 30 words per minute.
It was kind of hard, but it was surprisingly fast. And I thought it was going to take me weeks, but by the third day, I was already typing like without even thinking about it.
Maybe third week, I was up to 40 words per minute, so I could do most of my work. And by the fourth week, I was up to 60, 70 words per minute, which is my average speed. So I'd say 3 weeks took me to switch to Columnar.
Step three, find your space. Space is the most pressed key, and mistyping it will slow down your typing more than any other key. Most, if not all, ergonomic keyboards are split and have multiple thumb keys. This means that you need to find out which key in the thumb cluster is the most comfortable for you and your space. If you're not sure which one it is, you can set several thumb keys to be your space and find out which ones you actually press.
At first, I put my space key on both sides to see which side is more comfortable for me. But then I found out that I only press space with one of my sides. So the other side I assigned to a layer shift. I have it on the default thumb key with the bump that's designed, you know, for the home position of your hand.
When I use a normal keyboard, I notice that I only use my right thumb for space. So when I switch to my Columnar keyboard with so many thumb keys, I only assign one thumb key on the right hand. And on the other hand, I have backspace.
After mastering the alphas and finding your space, you're now ready to work on the thumb cluster. It's time to stop using your pinkies for the modifiers and start assigning them to the thumbs. Ask yourself what your most used modifiers are. It could be Control or Command, but most probably it's Shift. Start with those and add them to where you think it feels right to have them. Assigning a different color to these keys will help you get used to the new disposition. You can then start assigning dual function keys where you can have space or enter when you tap it and shift, control, or any modifier when you hold it. Columnar keyboards also have extra keys in the inner columns. They might not be comfortable for modifiers, but they open a world of possibilities. This brings us to the last step. Customize it your way. Once you've mastered steps 1 to 4, it's time to expand the possibilities. Create different layers, macros, super keys, and anything you need. You can have a layer for symbols, a number pad layer, and another one for navigation. The possibilities are endless. We recommend starting with one layer at a time, adding new keys slowly to avoid visual pollution and mental overload. If you want to learn all about layers, macros, and super keys, check out this playlist. And don't forget to practice. It takes time to master anything, so be patient. You can always have a backup plan, like having a staggered keyboard around in case you need it. Don't worry, learning a new layout won't wipe the staggered mechanics from your brain. It will just expand your skill set. Remember, retraining muscle memory requires perseverance. Eventually, it'll come naturally to you. Set realistic goals and start with the easy things before moving to more complex tasks. Try to beat your own time typing a pangram, such as the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, or the five boxing wizards jump quickly. In Spanish, Fabio me exige sin tapujos que añada cerveza al whisky. Or in German,
Victor jagt 12 Boxkämpfer quer über den großen Sylterdeich.
You're not going to match your previous typing speed that quickly, but a realistic goal would be to get at least 75% of it within the next 3 months. If you aim to improve your health and reduce finger travel, focus on comfort and better posture rather than performance. Hopefully, you've learned a thing or two from this video and you'll soon be using your Ortholinear or Columnar keyboard like a pro. Victor van Vinkting Schwing.